Hello my loves, it's Monica and welcome back to my channel. I am so excited today because today I'm going to be sharing with you all the process of putting together my cozy, pastel, wonderful library. I am so excited to have just a really cute and cozy space to have all of my books, to curl up on a comfy chair and read, and I'm so excited to share this process with all of you guys. Before I dive in, I did want to just thank Nathan, James, who were so kind, and they actually sent over 3 of their Theo bookcases to me, and I love their Theo bookcases. I just think they're so beautiful. I love how tall they are because especially in our apartment, we have really tall ceilings, so I really wanted to fill that as much as I could. So I was on the hunt for like white, tall bookcases that were something a little bit different. Like I didn't really want, I've had the Billy bookcases from IKEA before and they're nice, I like them, but I just wanted something different, you know? And I love these. I love how like they look so expensive, but they are like pretty affordable. Like in my old apartment, I had one of these bookcases and I loved it, but I wanted to go for like an all white look. So the vibe for this room at least is like very like 80s inspired, but also like inspired by a lot of like Korean decor bloggers. So that's like the vibe I'm going for, very pastel, very cozy. And yeah, they just fit so perfectly into the style that I was going for. And I'm just really thankful that they sent these my way. So just wanted to mention them. I will be sure to link the bookshelves down below in case you want to check them out. And I'll try to link as much as I can down below. I will throw out there that like some pieces have been thrifted or I've just had for many years. So sorry in advance if anything can't be linked. But yeah, I'm just so proud of this cozy, cute pastel space. It's truly the cozy library of my dreams. And without further ado, I'm gonna pass it on over to me from the past to share this process. Hello friends. So it is a day. So we have moved officially. We are in our new space. And today I'm so excited because I'm going to be setting up my bookcases. And yeah, that's basically going to have the biggest impact on just like this situation because it is quite chaotic in here right now. And I just need it to not be. But yeah, this is my office. I guess I'll do a quick little early office tour so you could see what it's looking like. So here is from the entryway. So my bookcases are gonna go over there on that wall. And then my desk area is over here. And I haven't really done anything there other than set up my desk. So obviously I have to do that. And then my dresser, also have to do all the setup for that. And then over here, I'm gonna have a curtain sort of blocking this off. I don't know why they didn't just put a closet door, but whatever. And then I bought like some shelving, like a shelving unit that I'll put inside so I can have some better use of this storage. So unfortunately, the first order of business for me today is moving all of this stuff behind me because I obviously need this space so that we can hang up my bookcases. I also need to build the bookcases. I have a guy coming in like 3 hours who's meant to mount them onto the wall, and also like a few other bits in the apartment. So yes, here's hoping I can accomplish as much of that as possible. Okay, y'all, I've built one bookcase. It looks so good. I'm so excited. I'm gonna have 3 here, so big wall of books. I'm not sure if I want it to be as tight to this corner or not, though. That is the one question I'm not sure about. My goal was to have all these built before the guy who is attaching them to the wall got here. I don't know if I'm gonna actually accomplish that. Actually, I'm pretty sure I will not be accomplishing that, so I might have him help me build at least one of them. They're really easy to build. It's just cumbersome because they're like heavy and I am weak. So yeah, but otherwise like they're very, very easy to build. Like everything just like goes into its place. But oh boy, am I sweaty. So it is the next day and there has been some movement around my bookcases. So yesterday I was putting one of the cases together because I hired a handyman to come and attach them to the walls, and I got through the one. It took me like almost an hour, and I was running really late, and so by the time I finished the one, he had just arrived, and I was gonna build the other two while he was hanging the first one, but he hung the first one in like 5 minutes, and he was like, "Do you want help?" And then he then subsequently built the two other bookcases in like 15 minutes. That was a little embarrassing, but you know what? We each have our own skills, and building things is apparently his. Anyways, he ended up building and attaching my bookcases to the wall, and now I have them attached, and it's time for me to put up my books. I've been trying to decide what kind of order I wanted to organize my books in. I've never really had this much bookshelf space, at least like since I lived in Pennsylvania with my family. Honestly, this is even more space than that, so I really have space to like play with the organization method that I'm gonna be using, and I don't think I have enough books to really fill this whole space. I am thinking that I will be able to do some decorating on my shelves versus like having them jam-packed with books. I'm excited to get started today in just putting up all of my books onto these shelves. I know I definitely want another like Korean shelf, so I might do that. And I usually like to keep my like favorite red books together too. So yeah, I don't know. We'll see. So I attempted to put curtains up and lived my worst nightmare, which is standing on step stools. I just find them horrifying. I'm horribly afraid of not heights, but of low heights. So terribly afraid of step stools, totally fine on like sides of cliffs. I don't know. Anyways, put them up and immediately the curtains fell down. So luckily at that point, my friend Jeffrey was here and he is very tall and he hung them for me. So now I have curtains. So the sun is less blinding. And now I'm just putting up some books at the moment. I have some of my faves, like my Diviner series from Fairy Loot. And then of course the Grishaverse is gonna be on the shelf too. Guys, okay, I'm getting so freaking excited because I have space in my room. Not much space, but a little bit more space. Getting some boxes taken down. And I have a lot of books. I think the majority of my books are currently on my shelves, which is also kind of worrying me because I definitely have more space than books, which is a good thing. That's what I wanted. I wanted to be able to grow my collection over time versus like starting with a packed shelf like I did in the previous apartment. But yeah, I'm trying to figure out how I want to organize all of this. I'm just kind of trying to get stuff on the shelves right now, and then gonna just like have a think about the organization method that I want. The issue is that like I have a few authors where I own quite a bit of their works and I want to keep them together, but then I also do kind of like the idea of sorting by genre. But to be honest, I mostly own fantasy and then like a smattering of other things. So, and then I also want like my Korean shelf and that spans all genres. Yeah, so I don't know, I'm trying to figure it out. But anyways, this is where we are at so far. There's my bookcases and my curtains. And I think I want to do like a cute little chair over there eventually, but yeah, I am feeling very good about this. Thank you. Okay, so it is like 7:30 at night and I have been at this for quite a few hours, and this is where we're at so far. I'll give you a quick little look at the current status. So earlier I mentioned how I thought maybe I had not enough books to fill my bookcases. That was a lie. Yeah, I definitely have enough books. I'm honestly a little bit overwhelmed by the amount of books that I somehow have. I genuinely don't understand how I'm filling all of this, because in my last room I had one of these and that was it. So I'm not sure how I'm suddenly filling three of them. Although, to be fair, I have not put anything on the top shelves, and not really a ton on the bottom shelves. So I guess that's part of it. And also, I did have a book tower in my room, and I don't know if I'm going to be utilizing that, because I do think everything is going to fit very nicely on these three, and I honestly don't want to grow my library beyond this. So like, if I'm bringing in books, I want to be, you know, donating books. So yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be using that. I might just be like selling that or something. But yeah, I'll give a quick little look over of what I've done so far today. So this bookcase is, I think, going to be housing basically all fantasy. On this shelf are like my faves, like Brandon Sanderson and N.K. Jemisin and some others. Some that I have read, some that I need to read. Then over here I have like literary slash classics, I think are going to be like these two shelves. And then of course I have like my diviners books, so like more favorites. These are absolute favorites on this shelf too. So like the diviners, Leigh Bardugo, Robin Hobb. And then under that, this was actually amazing to put together. This, every time I put together a new book, like library area, I am always so excited to see that my Korean books have grown so much. So this is my, this whole section plus this are all of my Korean books, and then I have my K-pop albums plus two Taylor Swift albums. Then down here I have a bunch of Book of the Month books, my manga, and I'll probably put like graphic novels and stuff down here. That's what all of this is. And then I have like a small mystery thriller section, some more classics, my middle grade, and yeah, this is where we're at right now. I need to do some cleaning up, some reorganizing, thinking through how I really want to display these. So I'm not sure if this is going to be how everything is in the end, but this is how things are so far. So it is a new day and we are going to continue tackling these shelves. Honestly, I was getting really overwhelmed in that last clip. I think I was just like stressed about, you know, having my shelves look the best that they could look. But then I realized that was silly and that I can obviously change them. But yeah, time to continue just putting the books on here and hopefully getting some sort of semblance of organization happening. So it is a couple days later and I have been just doing a lot of organizing, cleaning, all of that. I don't want to show you the rest of the room yet. That's going to be a future video, but I'm so excited. I have a floor finally. I've just been like slowly making my way through boxes and just trying to get this room into a space where I can be creative and work and all of that. And I'm really excited about it. It's looking so good so far. I've been basically doing a lot of work on my shelves. I think I've finalized the organization that I'm going with, which is kind of like organized chaos, basically. Like, nothing really makes a ton of sense. Like, I do have my Korean shelf, and I have like all of my fantasy together. My like favorite fantasies are all like on these two shelves right here. But then there's like some favorites that just didn't make this cut that are also on other shelves. And then I have like, I'll do like a whole like little bookshelf tour at the end, but yeah. And then I just have like a lot of little bits, little decor bits and stuff on the shelves just to add some personality. And I'm not 100% like certain that this is what it's gonna look like, but as of right now, I'm pretty happy with this. And then I also got a couple bits. So I got this lamp that is currently off camera right now. I got this amazing lamp off Facebook Marketplace. Honestly, like half of my decor and furniture is thrifted in some capacity, which I really like. Like, I love like thrifting and just finding really unique pieces. Anyways, I got this amazing like swirl lamp, and it has like multicolored pastel speckles in it, and it's like a very pale pink. So I've been calling it my funfetti lamp because that's what it looks like. And I also got this chair. This one I actually got from Target. I've been wanting it for a while, but it was just like a little bit too expensive, and it went on clearance, so I snapped it up. So I'm gonna put this together, and we will be one step closer to my cozy little library, and I'm so excited. It is yet another day, and I'm hoping to actually wrap things up today. I'm just going to be hanging up some art over here, and then I think it will be time for the full reveal. I'm so excited. We're done. Oh my goodness. I cannot believe that the space is finished. I'm absolutely obsessed with it. I definitely have a lot of work to do throughout the rest of my office, but this space is just everything I could have ever wanted it to be. It is the pastel cozy library of my dreams. And now I'm gonna do a little bit of a low-key bookcase bookshelf tour. I know everyone loves bookshelf tours. I personally am not into the style of like going through every single book and telling you about them, but I am gonna go through and tell you about each of the shelves, what's on there, and we're going to start that now. All right, up here on this first shelf is a collection of mostly contemporary stories. I have also a very small collection of 4 nonfiction books, so those are all up there. Then down on this shelf, we have my paperback fantasy novels, and then decorating the shelves, I have this beautiful vintage Fenton vase and the Miss Piggy Pez I actually got at the Pez Museum from like a road trip that I went on with my friends, and then just some like childhood mementos next to those. Then down here we have some favorite fantasies, and then in this area I have a crown, because why not? And I also have a cute little mushroom candle that smells delightful. It's from Urban Outfitters, and a little Totoro figurine. Then going down we have some hardcover fantasy, and on here I have a cute little strawberry jar, and oh my gosh, this flask I got at Hadestown, and I love the quote. Main reason why I got it: the world we dream about and the one we live in now. Ugh, I'm obsessed with it. I'm obsessed with Hadestown. If you have not seen it or heard it, highly recommend. And then down here we have some more fantasy and then my collection of Olive E. Blake books. Now up here I have a collection of literary fiction along with some historical fiction. Then below that I have some classics, so my Jane Austen collection, my new Anne of Green Gables collection, which is so beautiful. I'm obsessed with these vintage editions that I got off of eBay. They're so pastel and beautiful and perfect. And then over on the left is a lovely photo of my family because I love my family, so have to have them up on my shelves. Then here, right in the middle of everything, are some more of my all-time favorite books. Of course, we have the stunning Diviners set. This is from Fairy Loot, and I love them so much. To finally have a set of beautiful editions of the Diviners that all match is amazing. And they played off of the original cover. So this was the original one. This is Lair of Dreams. So they're absolutely beautiful. I love these. Oh, and they have black sprayed edges. So yeah, those are definitely some treasured pieces. Then I have these cuties. I got this Totoro figurine at the Ghibli Museum, and it's also like a little music toy. So if I wind it up, it plays the Totoro theme song, and it's so lovely. And then just a little Totoro there. And then of course my Leigh Bardugo collection, because she is my favorite author in the whole entire world. My perfume collection next to that. Then down here, taking up 1.5 shelves, is my Korean books collection, which is definitely one of my pride and joys. It brings me so much happiness to have this many books that are by Korean authors telling Korean stories. It just warms my heart every time. And then I have a few vintage pieces, this like vintage watering can, and I put my little Rilakkuma from Japan. It's the little Tokyo Station one, and I love him. And then I also have this cute little vintage cottage that my roommate gave me. Then down here I have my manga, and this also continues on to the next shelf, and it turns into all of my like graphic novels, and then just like randomly a couple series in John Green books. So this is kind of when I started just shoving things places. And then down here on the bottom shelves I have like notebooks, and then over here I have books that I need to, that I'm basically going to be lending out, or I just didn't have a spot for them yet, so they live there for now. All right, we're on the third bookcase. So up here we have all of my Book of the Month books. They fit so perfectly on the shelf, so I just kept them all there and all together. So yeah, this is one where like obviously these books span different genres, but I just decided to keep them together because they look so nice together. Then down here I have murder mystery, thriller, and my one horror novel. So that's that section. And of course I have my lovely Hello Kitty cookie jar and that rainbow snow globe, which I love. Then we have mostly middle grade down here. And oh my gosh, look at my little Namjoon standee. I love him. But yeah, mostly middle grade. I have like a collection of some like tiny books over here, but that is this section. And then now we're getting into the other shelves that I've kind of already showed you guys, but the rest of my Korean shelf is here, and then my K-pop albums and my ARMY bomb are all down here. And then yeah, these are my bookshelves. I'm also a little bit flabbergasted as to how I filled all of these, to be honest, because in my last apartment I had one bookshelf and a book tower, and somehow it has turned into this. To be fair, I did have a lot of books on my floor. I just didn't realize I had this many books on my floor. So there you go. Oh, and then I did hang up a couple pieces of art. I have these. I got them off of Etsy. I will link the shop down below. And I love them. I think they're so cute. And I think here I'm gonna have like a little table for like chilling, eating, doing some sewing projects, so that'll probably go here. But yeah, that is everything. That is the full process of how I put together these shelves. I'm so proud of this space and so in love with it. And yeah, I'm just so excited for this to be my little library. I will definitely be filming and just creating lots of content in front of these shelves. So very excited for that too. But thank you all so, so much for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your day, and I'll talk to you next time. Bye!